with the topic, the last topic, have to, remember, have to. So let's put these words in order, in the right order. Say I. What is the next word?
Have to.
Yes, have to.
Go to work now.
Yeah, very good. Go to work now. Excellent. Tengo que ir a trabajar ahora. Okay, this is a question.
Have to.
No, it's a question, so first is auxiliary. Do
we have to?
Do we have to?
Talk about these.
Yes.
Talk about this now.
Okay.
And my question.
Very good. Excellent. Okay, the subject, you.
You have to.
It's negative, so you don't. You don't have
to. No sé por qué, pero es que no veo la pantalla completa, o sea, no la veo bien.
Ah, oh, ok.
Ok, y ahora sí la veo bien. Igual. Es que a veces se me burla la pantalla y se me pone un sale el lado.
You don't have to come if
you don't want to.
Yes, if you don't want to. Good. No tienes que venir si no quieres. Okay, very good. Okay, let's do another exercise about must. Must. We are going to put the words in the right order. Okay. I I must. Yes, very good. I must
visit my grandmother. Grandmother tomorrow. Grandmother.
Pay my sick grandmother tomorrow. Recordemos que el adjetivo va antes del sustantivo, entonces sick va antes. Okay. Okay. Now we're going to put in the right order this sentence.
The decision.
Okay, the decision.
Must week. Build her next week.
I don't know. Let me think. I'm not sure about it. Okay, that's not quiet. You can clear the hit the button plug. Okay, no, that's not correct. So tell me another. Could be the judge, I think so. I don't know. The next view. Let me check. Yes. No era the decision, sino the dupe. The dupe must make her decision next week. El juicio debe tomar su decisión la próxima semana. Okay. Good. Okay, that's it for this topic. We're going to study another topic, okay? But do you have any question about this topic? Okay, no questions. So let's continue with a new topic. The topic is should. Should. This is another modal verb. We're going to learn another modal verb, should. Okay. Should is a modal verb most commonly used to make recommendations or give advice. It can also be used to express obligation as well as expectation. Ok, should es un verbo modal comúnmente usado para hacer recomendaciones o dar consejos. También se puede utilizar para expresar obligaciones y expectativas.
Teacher, ¿y should en español qué significa?
Debería.
Oh, thank you.
Ok. You're welcome. For example, when you go to Berlin, you should visit the palace in Potsdam. Okay, this is a recommendation. Esto es una recomendación. Cuando tú vayas a Berlín, deberías visitar los palacios de Potsdam. Es como una recomendación, ¿cierto? Una recomendación. Pues para ello, uso should antes de el verbo, right? Another example, you should focus more on your family and less on work. This is advice, an advice. Este es un consejo. Deberías enfocarte más en tu familia y menos en el trabajo. The next one, I really should be in the office by 7 a.m. This is an obligation, una obligación. También lo utilizamos para expresar obligaciones. Por ejemplo, realmente debería estar en la oficina a las 7 de la mañana. And the last one, by now, they should already be in Dubai. This is an expectation. Esta es una expectativa. For example, a estas alturas ya deberían estar en Dubai. Expresando algo que espero que esté pasando. Okay, now when do we use it? Should. Bueno, vamos a ver cuándo lo usamos. Entonces, para choose for advice and opinions. Entonces, para consejos y opiniones. For example. Okay, we often use should when offering advice or opinions. Entonces, lo usamos también a menudo cuando vamos a ofrecer, vamos a dar un consejo o una opinión, como ya lo había dicho anteriormente. Acá hay otros ejemplos. Here I have more examples. You should see the new James Bond movie. It's great. Deberías ver la nueva película de James Bond. Es fantástica. You should try to lose weight. Deberías intentar perder peso. John should get a haircut. John debería cortarse el cabello. He shouldn't smoke and he should stop drinking too. No debería fumar y él también debería dejar de beber. What should I wear? What should I wear? ¿Qué debería usar? Cuando hago pregunta, estoy antes, no estoy dando un consejo, sino antes estoy pidiéndolo, ¿cierto? Que me den un consejo. What should I wear, por ejemplo? Como en este ejemplo. ¿Qué debería usar? What should I wear? Estoy pidiendo a los demás que me den un consejo o que me den una opinión, right?
Teacher, I have a question.
Yes, tell me.
Y show también se puede usar en negativo.
Yes, of course. Ya lo vamos a ver.
Okay, teacher.
Thank you. Should for obligation, duty, and correctness. Entonces, should para obligaciones, deberes y correcciones. Another use of should is to indicate a kind of obligation, duty, or correctness, often when criticizing another person. También, should puede ser usado para para indicar un tipo de obligación, un deber o corrección a menudo cuando se critica a otra persona. For example, you should be wearing your seatbelt. Obligation. Deberías llevar puesto el cinturón de seguridad. ¿Sí? Estoy dando como, es una obligación. Pero es más que todo como un consejo a la persona. No lo estoy obligando tanto como cuando uso must or have to, right? En este caso es como dando más como un consejo, okay? I should be at work now. Adoti. Es un deber. Debería estar en el trabajo ahora. Correctness. Una corrección. For example, you shouldn't have said that to her. No deberías haberle dicho eso. Una corrección. Ahí está, aquí está un ejemplo en forma negativa. Shouldn't es la contracción en forma negativa. Shouldn't. The pronunciation is shouldn't. Shouldn't. Se agrega la N, la apóstrofe y la T. Okay. You shouldn't have said that to her. No deberías haberle dicho eso a ella. Okay. Should for probability and expectation. Para probabilidades y expectativas, también lo podemos usar. We use should to indicate that we think something is probable, we expect it to happen. For example, are you ready? The train should be here soon. ¿Estás listo? El tren debería llegar pronto. Es una expectativa, algo que yo estoy esperando. Entonces lo estoy expresando, ¿cierto? $10 is enough. It shouldn't cost more than that. $10 es suficiente. No debería costar más que eso. It shouldn't, también está otra oración negativa. No debería costar más de eso. And the last one. Let's call Mary. She should have finished work by now. Llamemos a Mary. Ya debería haber terminado de trabajar. Es una probabilidad, una expectativa, ¿cierto? Probablemente ella ya terminó de trabajar o yo espero que ella ya haya terminado de trabajar. Entonces lo expreso de esta manera. She should have finished work by now. Using should. Yeah. Okay, now let's look up the structure of should. The basic structure for should is subject plus auxiliary verb should plus main verb. Okay. That's it basic. It's basic. El sujeto, el verbo auxiliar should y el verbo principal. Note that the auxiliary verb should is invariable. There is only one form should. Ok, tengamos en cuenta que el auxiliar should, este verbo auxiliar should, no cambia. O sea, es la misma forma para los diferentes pronombres personales. Con I, she, he, we, they, no cambia. Es el mismo, should, right? And the main verb is usually in the base form, he should go. Y el verbo principal suele estar en la forma básica, o sea, en su forma infinitiva, sin el to, right? Como está acá el ejemplo, he should go. Forma infinitiva, el verbo está en su forma infinitiva, sin el to. O sea, no decimos he should to go, no, sin el to, right? Okay. Okay, look at the basic structure again with positive, negative, and question sentences. Okay, positive sentence. He should work. He should work. Él debería trabajar. Negative. You should not go. You should not go. Ustedes no deberían ir. O tú no deberías ir. And the question, should we help? Should we help? ¿Deberíamos nosotros ayudar? Should we help? A question, right? Must is stronger than should. Ok, ¿cuál es la diferencia con must? Uno es deber y el otro es debería, ¿cierto? Entonces, must es más fuerte. O sea, es más obligación, no, más obligatorio que cuando uso should. For example, it's a good film. You should go and see it. Or with must. It's a fantastic film. You must go and see it. Es una buena película, deberías ir y verla. En cambio, con must, es una fantástica película, debes ir y verla. ¿Cierto? Es como estoy obligando más a la persona. Ok. Another way to say should is off to. Off to. Esta es otra manera de decir should, significa lo mismo. Ought to. Es bueno que lo sepan porque muchas veces también lo van a poder encontrar. Y es el mismo should. Ought to. Pero es más común should que ought to. Ought to. It's a good film. You ought to go and see it. I think Carol ought to buy some new clothes. The meaning is the same. El significado es el mismo. Ok. Ought to or should. Bueno, como les decía, ought to and should are similar in meaning. Should is more common than ought to. Ought to is more formal than should. Bueno, acá hay unas diferencias. El significado es el mismo, solo que should es más común. Y ought to es más formal que should. For example, there ought to be more street lights here.
Teacher, ¿y should o ought en español qué significa?
Debería. Ya.
Sea, es lo mismo que el de ahorita.
Sí, el significado es el mismo.
Okay, teacher. O sea, el significado es el mismo, sino que es más común.
Should es más común.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Okay, you're welcome. For example, there ought to be more street lights here. Means the same as there should be more street lights here. Debería haber más semáforos aquí. Lo mismo que con should. Debería haber más semáforos aquí. Lo mismo. I really ought to walk my dog more. It's so fat. Means the same as I really should walk my dog more. It's so fat. Lo único que cambia es should y acá ought to. Y lo mismo. Realmente debería pasear a mi perro, más a mi perro. Está tan gordo. It's the same. Okay, now let's practice. Let's practice. We're going to complete this sentence. The sentence is, you should last one of these birds. Okay, you should and one of these birds. Y uno de estos verbos. For example, number one is an example. When, sorry. One moment.
Teacher, I have a question.
Yes.
Sorry, es que me interesa. Porque, o sea, should y es, o sea, se puede utilizar o sea, la otra palabra también se puede utilizar en vez de should. O sea, si se pueden utilizar en todo o son diferentes.
Se pueden utilizar las dos, solo que should es más utilizada que la otra.
Okay,
Por eso dije, es más común, o sea, es más utilizada should que ought to.
Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. So, number one, when you play tennis, you should watch the ball. Cuando juegues tenis, deberías ver la pelota. Number two. It's late and you are very tired.
You should go to bed.
Okay. Very good. You should go to bed. Very good. Yes. Es tarde y estás muy cansado. Deberías irte a dormir. Okay, very good. Next, the next one. Three. Number three.
You should clean.
Yes, that's right. You should clean. You should clean your teeth twice a day. Deberías limpiar o lavar tus dientes dos veces al día. Okay, number four.
You should visit.
One moment. Okay, if you have time,
you should visit.
You should visit, yes. Okay, you should visit. If you have time, you should visit the Science Museum. It's very interesting. Tienes tiempo, deberías visitar el Museo de Ciencia. Es muy interesante. Number five, when you're driving,
you should wear.
You should wear. Yes, that's right. When you are driving, you should wear a seatbelt. Cuando estés conduciendo, deberías usar el cinturón de seguridad. Number six, it's too far to talk from here to the station.
You should take.
You should take a taxi. Yes. It's too far to walk from here to the station. You should take a taxi. Está lejos caminar de aquí a la estación. Deberías tomar un taxi. Okay, very good. Let's continue with this exercise. We are going to write about the people in the pictures. Use he or she, shulen, so. For example, number one, you watch TV too much. Tú ves televisión mucho. You watch TV too much. So the sentence is, she chulen watch TV so much. Vamos a cambiar el to por el so, okay? So number two, you eat too much.
She shouldn't eat so much. She shouldn't to eat so much.
No usamos to, remember, don't use to. He shouldn't eat so much. Yeah, that's right. She shouldn't eat so much. Good. Number three. You work too hard.
Teacher, ¿qué significa hard?
Duro, difícil. Tú trabajas muy duro.
And fast.
Rápido.
Oh, thank you. You shouldn't. You shouldn't work too hard. Sorry.
You shouldn't work so hard.
Okay, is he or she? She shouldn't. Work so hard. Okay, good. And number four, you drive too fast.
He shouldn't drive so fast.
Okay. She shouldn't drive so fast. Good. Okay, think plus should. We don't use I think plus shouldn't. We use I don't think plus should. Bueno, cuando va a hacer una oración con I think y voy a decir lo negativo, no hago la negación en el should, sino en el think. O sea que uso el verbo auxiliar don't. I don't think should. I don't think should. No creo que deberías. I don't think should. For example, I think you shouldn't go there. It's not correct. This is not correct because we don't have the negative shouldn't. after I think. Instead, we made the verb think negative and say, I don't think you should go there. This is correct. Que la forma correcta sería, I don't think you should go there. No creo que deberías ir allí. No pongo la negación en el should, sino en el think. Entonces, I don't think you should go there. ¿Okay? Esto solamente es cuando estoy utilizando think, I think. El verbo creer, o yo pienso que, o yo creo que. Right? Es cuando voy a decir una oración con esta frase. Okay? Entonces la negación no iría en el verbo auxiliar, sino en la frase de think. I don't think, I... Okay? A couple more examples. I don't think he should eat that. No creo que él debería comer eso. Or, I don't think we should start yet. No creo que deberíamos empezar todavía.
Teacher, I think es creo.
Yes. O pienso que.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay. So let's practice about think. You ask a friend for advice. Write questions with do you think I should? ¿Piensas que yo debería tal cosa? Okay. So number one, you are in a shop. You are trying on a jacket. Okay. Acá hay una situación. Entonces, tú estás en una tienda y te estás probando una chaqueta. So, you ask your friend, vas a, entonces a preguntarle a tu amigo, usando do you think I should, y el verbo buy, que está acá entre paréntesis. So, the question is, do you think I should buy this jacket? ¿Piensas que debería yo comprar esta chaqueta? Okay, number two, you can drive, and the verb is learned. So, you ask your friend, do you think, where is the complete sentence, the complete question, using learn, okay?
I learn to drive.
I should learn to drive. Yes, I should learn to drive. Do you think I should learn to drive? Entonces le preguntas a tu amigo, ¿crees que debería yo aprender a conducir? ¿O piensas que debería yo aprender a conducir? Ok, number three. Estoy pidiendo un consejo a mi amigo, right? Okay, and then number three. You don't like your job. I'm sorry. What happened? Okay, number three. You don't like your job. Get another job. You ask your friend.
Do you think I should another job?
Do you think, yes,
I should job.
What is the verb? I should
get.
Yes, get another job. Excellent. Do you think I should get another job? Good. ¿Piensas que debería encontrar otro trabajo. Okay, number four. You are going to have a party. Invite Gary. You ask your friend. I'm sorry.
Do you think I should invite Gary?
Do you think I should
do you think I should invite Gary?
Yes. Right. I should invite Gary. ¿Crees que debería invitar a Gary? Okay, very good. Okay, so let's continue with this exercise. We're going to write sentence with I think should or I don't think should. Number one, it's late. Go home now. I think we should go home now. Two, that coat is too... Okay. De acuerdo a la situación que nos digan, entonces creo o no creo que debería hacerlo, ¿cierto? Por ejemplo, en la primera, es tarde. Ir a casa ahora. Entonces, yo creo que nosotros deberíamos ir a casa ahora, ¿cierto? En esta ocasión sería I think, no I don't think, ¿cierto? Number two, that coat is too big for you. Buy it. Acá no creo que deberías comprarlo. ¿Por qué? Porque le queda grande esa chaqueta. Number three, you don't need your car. Sell it. Okay. So I think or I don't think. What is it?
I think.
I think you should sell it.
Okay, very good. I think you should sell it. Number four, Diane needs a rest. Have a holiday.
I don't think you should have a holiday.
No. I don't think.
I think.
Or I think.
I think.
I think.
Yes. I think. Yes, it's better.
You should have a holiday.
Day.
Yes.
Holiday.
Yes, that's right. I think you should have a holiday. Creo que, okay, you know, sino que estamos hablando de Diane. So, I think she should have a holiday. Creo que ella debería tener unas vacaciones. ¿Por qué? Está cansada, mira, necesita un descanso. Diana necesita un descanso. Entonces la oración por eso es con I think, right? Ok, number five. Sally and Colin are too young. Get married.
I don't think.
Yes.
I don't think you should get married.
They should get married.
Yes. They should get married. They, porque estamos hablando de Sally y Colin, ellos, right? I don't think they should get married. Okay, good. Number six. You are not well this morning. Go to work.
I don't think you should go to work.
I don't think you should go to work.
Yes, that's right. I don't think you should go to work. No creo que deberías ir a tu a trabajar. Okay, number seven.
I think you should go. I think you should go to the doctor.
Okay, James isn't well today. I think.
You should go to the doctor.
Okay, he should go to the doctor. And the last one, number eight. The hotel is too expensive for us. Stay there.
I don't think you should stay there.
Stay there.
I don't think, yes, I don't think. They should stay there. Okay, very good. Good job. Okay, I have another exercise. Let me check. Okay, this exercise, we're going to choose the correct option. Okay, number one. You should to stop or not smoking.
To stop.
Which one?
To stop.
No, stop. Yes, stop. Very good. You should stop smoking. No usamos to, remember. To, no. Con should, no. Con ningún verbo.
Es que me confundo mucho.
Don't worry. Okay. You should stop smoking. Number two. What do you think I should to, or shouldn't to do?
Should.
Yes, very good. What do you think I should do? Number three, people should understand that the world has changed.
Understanding.
Understand. Yeah, that's right. Understand. El verbo no lo modificamos. No va con ing ni con s. Va infinitivo. Okay.
Sorry, teacher.
People should understand that the world has changed. Number four. Those children, they should too, or should be at school.
Should.
Good. Yes. Those children should be at school. Excellent. That motorcyclist
should.
Yes. That motorcyclist should be wearing a helmet. Yeah. Very good. Number six. You paid 99, it
shouldn't.
Okay, one, two, or three.
Shouldn't.
Three.
Yeah, that's right. Shouldn't.
Three.
If I won the lottery, I
should.
Okay, vamos a dejar hasta acá. That's it for today.
Teacher, I have a question.
Yes, tell me.
Porque todos los días terminamos sin.
Thanks for the class, miss.
Okay,
todos los días terminamos 5 minutos antes.
Yes, because I have another class.
No entiendo.